Alfred, I don't think this is very funny. Bobby, who is this?
As you watch the screen, your heart begins to beat faster. There's a fluttering in the pit of your stomach. Your throat is dry. Your palms damp. Suddenly a chill runs down your spine. You clutch the person next to you. You tell yourself, it's only a movie.
It's only a movie. But sooner or later, it's time to go home. Question about it. Some terror films go too far.
Mommy, unlock the door.
But so do the audiences.
I want you to go down the stairs and out the front door. I want you to go down the street to Mackenzie's house.
First they start grabbing each other, which is all very well if you have a date.
I want you to tell them to call the police.
And before long...
Now do you understand me?
No. No, baby, no,
people
no.
People are yelling no, no. at the characters on the screen.
Hey, watch out, baby. Watch out.
Please, Tom.
Get him.
Don't drop the knife, asshole.
It's strange, isn't it? In real life, nobody likes to think about violence, pain, blood, and death. But project these experiences on a screen, and people form lines in the street. That's because a terror film is a lot like a roller coaster ride. Only you're sitting in a theater, which is relatively safe.
Deep down, we have a need to be scared. Why else do we go to these movies? Perhaps we're taking a dare, proving to ourselves that we're not afraid.
Go ahead, Lonnie. Chicken, go in!
Hey. Hey, Lonnie, get your ass away from there.
Besides, there's something delicious about fear, especially somebody else's. Scary movies tap into your childhood fears of the dark and of being alone.
Young or old, we go to the movies to see our dreams and fantasies come to life. But not all of our fantasies are wholesome, dignified.
In the privacy of our thoughts, we can be as childish as we like. And the little scenarios of power and revenge we conjure up can be quite satisfying. Resorting to violence to get back at someone might not be your cup of tea.
Will you look at that fellow over there? I've never seen anything so disgusting in all my life.
But I'll bet you've thought about it.
He's staring. I think he's looking at us. I think we're being picked up. Oh, it's too awful. I don't know how they're going to look creatures like that.
Carry around a certain amount of resentment and rage because we can't let it out. In the movies, we can. The question is, why make up horrible things when there is so much real terror in the world?
Perhaps we invent artificial horrors to help us cope with the real ones.
In 1974, a picture came out that was inspired by a true story. It was called The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And in it, the character of Leatherface was based on Ed Gein, a mass murderer and grave robber who lived in a small isolated town. Gein was a cannibal, a necrophile, and a transvestite. But he didn't dress up in women's clothes. He dressed up in their skin.
No wonder these films give us nightmares.
Do I have to close my eyes?
It doesn't matter.
All right, yes, I have something.
Or is it our nightmares that give us these films? That's the trick, isn't it? Once the lights go down,
whatever you see, whatever you can't see, whatever you think you see, is out of your control. You're at the mercy of the filmmakers. When the camera takes on the point of view of the killer, we see what they see. Not who they are.
to see, I see you, my dear.
Michael!
Of course, you can always close your eyes, but you can't close your ears.
Keeping your eyes open is a good idea, especially if you're out on a night with a full moon, because you never know what's in store for you. Years ago, when filmmakers wanted to transform someone into a werewolf, the actor just sat still, and trick photography did all the work. Today, people are more sophisticated. And becoming a werewolf can take a lot out of you. Skill, ingenuity, and a strong stomach.
All right, I'm gonna suck your brain dry.
Artists and technicians continue to defy logic. Stagger the imagination and astound our senses all the time, raising the stakes.
But special effects are not essential to a good movie. It's the filmmaker's technique that matters most. And the unquestioned master was Alfred Hitchcock.
You just won a Cupid doll.
Why, he's broken the thing.
Is your name Marion?
When I say that I'm not interested in content, it's would be the same as a painter worrying about whether the apples that he's painting, whether they're sweet or sour. Who cares? It's his style, his manner of painting them. That's where the emotion comes from. This scene is 45 seconds long. but was made up out of 78 pieces of film coming onto the screen in great rapidity. But the overall impression given the audience is one of an alarming, devastating murder scene.
The fact is, from the moment you buy that ticket, you know you're going to get it. It's just a question of how, where, and when. The name of the game is suspense.
Cute, Bob, real cute. See anything you like? What's the matter? Can't I get your ghost, Bob? Where's my beer?
In effect, the filmmaker says to the audience, now get ready. You're going to see something that's going to scare you, but I'm not going to tell you when. You're being programmed to go nuts.
I met this 6-year-old child with this blank, pale, emotionless face. The blackest eyes, the devil's eyes. I spent 8 years trying to reach him, and then another 7 trying to keep him locked up. I realized that what was living behind that boy's eyes was purely and simply evil.
Well, can't you answer me? Okay, don't answer me. Are you weird? Well, I'm gonna call Lori. I wanna know where Paul and Annie are. This is going nowhere.
Finally. Hello? Hello? All right, Annie. First I get your famous chewing, now I get your famous squealing. Are you fooling around again?
Annie!
The essential fact is to get real suspense. You must let the audience have information. Now, let's take the old-fashioned bomb theory. You and I are sitting talking, we'll say, about baseball. We're talking for 5 minutes. Suddenly, a bomb goes off, and the audience have a 10-second terrible shock. Now, let's take the same situation. Tell the audience at the beginning that under the table, and show it to them, there's a bomb, and it's going to go off in 5 minutes. And we talk baseball. What are the audience doing? They're saying, don't talk about baseball. There's a bomb under there. Get rid of it. But they're helpless. They can't jump out of their seats up onto the screen and grab hold of the bomb and throw it out.
Shock and surprise are very different from suspense. If you want to shock people, you just have to catch them off guard. And then clobber them.
Oh, God!
Oh, no!
Don't touch it! Don't touch it!
That was shocking, wasn't it?
But suspense can be equally brutal.
Owes its very existence to the one group of characters devoted to its cause. The villains.
You.
From the Dangerously Disturbed.
Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord.
To the thoroughly demented. They run the gamut in age, appearance, even occupation.
Give me the money, you fucker.
And yet,
I'm not a bad man.
They can be encouraging.
All I want is for you to trust me.
Come on, baby, open up the door.
You're gonna hit me again.
Now you know you're the number one thing in my heart.
They can be disarming.
Come on, baby, open up the door. I'm out here all alone.
I'm going to have her make a daily drink for you that'll be fresher, safer, and more vitamin-rich than any pills on the market.
They can be reassuring.
Any questions you have, call me night or day. That's what I'm here for.
You may even be married to one.
Wendy, I'm home.
So that even when you're certain of who they really are,
there's still no guarantee that you're safe.
I know who you are, you murderer. I know who you are.
Help! The man needs help here. Help, quick! A doctor!
At times we can't help but marvel at their cleverness.
I swear you ain't gonna hit me again.
I ain't never gonna hit you. All I want to do is give you the kind of love you want, what you need. That's right. Come on, open the door. I cannot believe how stupid you are.
Slick and calculating. When it comes to cruelty, they seem so self-assured.
And you? What's your favorite toy?
Geraldine. What does she do?
And may we have Geraldine on the table, too?
Oh, we may not.
Why the hell not?
Because she's the referee.
The most compelling villains are often the most confident.
May I help you with anything?
Yes. Yes. Something special.
Oh, yes. I think you might be interested in something like this.
That's good. What is it?
I think you'd be interested in the s'mores, sir. Would you like to smell it? What do you think?
Could you wrap it up for me?
Certainly.
I'll be back in a couple of minutes.
All right.
You really are very pretty.
Well, thank you.
For each villain brings a style and a method to his madness.
United Press. I have an announcement to make for your international wire.
His real name is Hamer Reinhardt.
He has no network, no real organization. He improvises. He manages to succeed where others have failed. If he has changed his face, he will be more dangerous than ever.
Is this trip business or pleasure?
Pleasure, I know.
Nobody ever walks out on me. You understand me? Never! They never walk out on me.
Untroubled by conscience, their capacity for evil has no limit.
Lesson number one, Ginger.
Is it safe?
Are you talking to me?
Is it safe?
What's safe?
Some are capable of doing anything.
Is it safe?
I don't know what you mean.
You're gonna pay for what you did to Ginger.
What I did to Ginger is knock her around. So what, bitch? So what? That's good.
Asshole! She's dead! Yeah!
You set me up,
motherfucker!
Nobody sets me up, you understand? Nobody! Come on, shoot! Come on, cop, shoot! Come on, kill me! She's dead, fuckhead! Dead! You understand me? Dead! Dead! Come on, shoot! Come on! Come on! You understand me? Dead! Ah!
Leave us alone. We've done nothing.
You must be very proud. If you will come over.
No, you take me! What is happening?
Life.
Is there
a...
It's just
taking a woman. He's bringing her to the front of the tram car. He has her against the window.
What the hell is he doing?
Get a little closer. I just want to see his face.
This one's for you, De Silva.
Oh, Christ, don't do it. And Susie.
Yes, Mike?
I want you to know it.
Mike!
In the end, they simply don't distinguish between right and wrong. Perhaps they don't know the difference. Perhaps they just don't care. Whether they're ruthless, desperate.
What I did to Ginger, it ain't nothing. Ah! What I'm gonna do to you.
Or totally deranged. However unstable the villains.
Why'd you kill the woman?
I wanted to.
So why don't you kill me?
In due time.
They are the ultimate figures in power.
That hurt?
No, I just think it would. Should take better care of your teeth. You have quite a cavity here. Is it safe?
Look, I tell you, I can't do it.
So no matter how much they make us hate them, they know how to make us watch them.
Find you, bitch. Please stop.
Please don't worry. I'm not going into that cavity. That nerve's already dying. A live, freshly cut nerve is infinitely more sensitive.
So, I'll just drill into a healthy tooth until I reach the pulse. Unless, of course, you can tell me that it's safe.
Walk up!
Life can be that simple. Relief, discomfort. Now, which of these I next apply? That decision is in your hands. So, take your time and tell me, is it safe?
are all born helpless. As infants, we are dependent on others for food, shelter, for life itself. We are totally vulnerable. Slowly but surely, we learn to be afraid.
Michael! Did you hear your father? Out of the water now! Now!
We're taught the difference between right and wrong. And yet, we're only human. And we sometimes take foolish risks, even when we know it's dangerous. By the time we regret what we've done, it may already be too late. What's most frightening of all?
Bobby?
Have you checked the children?
What?
Is that for reasons beyond our control? For reasons beyond our comprehension? Or worst of all, for no reason whatsoever.
The hat. I want the hat.
At any time. At any place. We may find ourselves a victim.
What are you, some kind of asshole?
Since vulnerability is the key, the victim is usually alone.
Hello?
Why haven't you checked the children?
And unfortunately, in these movies, the victim is almost always a woman.
It's a man. I think he's trying to scare me.
Anonymous caller, ma'am?
That's right.
Yeah, it's probably just some weirdo. The city's full of them.
Wendy, let me explain something to you. Whenever you come in here and interrupt me, you're breaking my concentration. You're distracting me. And it will then take me time to get back to where I was. Understand?
Yeah.
And we're gonna make a new rule. Whenever I'm in here, you hear me typing. Whether you don't hear me typing, whether the fuck you hear me doing in here, when I'm in here, that means that I am working. That means don't come in. Think you can handle that?
Yeah. What's wrong with the boss?
Nothing for you to worry about. Just get some rest right now. I'll let you know as soon as we get a hold of your parents.
To make things worse, she may be fully aware of the danger, but helpless to do anything about it.
I need you here. Here at the house.
Giving the villains an edge they are only too willing to exploit.
You've got to come over right away. Please, before she comes back.
No! On the other hand, she may be totally unaware that she is in any danger at all.
I have a telegram for Dr. Potter.
Well, he's not in. I'll take it.
I may only give it to him.
Well, I'm his wife. I think he'd give it to me.
When will he return?
I don't know. Sometime this afternoon. You want to come back later?
You can rest assured I will.
Well, I'm very confused. I just need a chance to think things over.
You've had your whole fucking life to think things over. What good's a few minutes more gonna do you now?
Stay away from me. Please. Don't hurt me.
I'm not gonna hurt you.
Stay away from me.
Wendy.
Stay away.
Darling, light of my life. I'm not gonna hurt you. You didn't let me finish my sentence. I said, I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just gonna bash your brains in.
You wanted. Is that what you wanted?
No.
What do you want?
Your blood all over me.
Little pigs, let me come in. Not by the hair on your chinny chin chin. Then I'll huff, and I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in.
Please, can't you help me? I'm all alone here.
Okay, now take it easy. I'll tell you what, if this guy calls you again...
He will call again, I know he will.
All right, now calm down. Look, I can alert the phone company so that if he calls again, we can try to trace a call. Inside the house. Our squad car's on the way over there right now. Just get out of that house.
Here's Johnny! Wherever you are.
Oh,
You don't have to be looking for trouble to find it.
I have seen these flowers all over. They're growing like parasites on other plants. All of a sudden, where are they coming from?
Outer space?
What are you talking about? A space flower?
Well, why not a space flower? Why do we always expect metal ships?
Evil can come from anywhere. Arriving mysteriously from outer space. Or appearing suddenly here on Earth.
There's a fog bank out there.
On land or at sea. Environments once familiar. Even pleasurable. Become bewildering. And ominous. Concealing and protecting the enemy.
I want to see who it is.
No. Can't I stay for two more seconds?
What are you doing?
While leaving us.
Okay, okay, I'm going.
Exposed. Of course, nature is not always to blame.
I don't know what the hell's in there, but it's weird and pissed off, whatever it is.
Malevolent life forms from other worlds may jeopardize our position as the supreme beings on this planet.
See, what we're talking about here is an organism that imitates other life forms, and it imitates them perfectly. When this thing attacked our dogs, it tried to digest them, absorb them, and in the process, shape its own cells to imitate them.
That's not dog.
It's imitation. We got to it before it had time to finish.
Finish what?
See?
Police.
Wake up. They get you when you sleep. Sit up.
Wait right there, Mr. Bunnell.
How do you know my name?
Hang up, Matthew.
I didn't tell you my name.
Hang up.
I didn't tell them my name.
They're all a part of it. They're all pods, all of them. It's happening now. They grow out of those pods.
How do we fight what we don't understand? How can we triumph over the unknown? Evil doesn't have to come from another world to control life here on Earth. Our oldest fear, the devil himself, can take on any form. Even that of a child.
Have no fear, little one. I am here to protect thee.
Damien! Damien! Look at me! Look at me, Damien!
Keep away! The sow is mine!
me!
Please come in.
More frightening still are those who worship the power of evil.
That whole bunch, the parties with the singing and the flute and the chanting, those are espas or sabbats.
Honey, don't get excited.
Read what they do, Guy. They use blood in their rituals, and the blood that has the most power is baby's blood. And they don't just use the blood, they use the flesh, too.
Rosemary, for God's sakes.
They're not setting foot in this apartment ever again. And they're not coming within 50 feet of the baby.
They're old people. They have a bunch of old friends. Dr. Shand happens to play the recorder.
They're not taking any chances with the baby's safety.
Well, you're not going.
Aretha Wood.
You tell that boy you're not going or we're going to move from here.
No.
Move from here and you'll never see that boy again.
The potential for evil may be hidden within all of us. Most of us never discover it.
Please talk to me!
Some of us do.
I'm going. You can't stop me. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Who are we?
Are you comfortable, Reagan?
Yes.
How old are you?
12.
Is there someone inside you?
Sometimes.
Somebody in this camp, being what he appears to be, right now that may be one or two of us. By spring, it could be all of us.
So how do we know who's human? If I was an imitation, a perfect imitation, how would you know if it was really me?
I'm speaking to the person inside of Reagan now. If you are there, you too are hypnotized. I must answer all my questions. Come forward. And answer me now.
What is inside us? And what if that which we held back suddenly were let go?
Father, not Guy.
No! No!
Please, Daddy, no! No, Daddy, no!
Father,
where evil plays without rules, no one is beyond reach.
Amen.
It's no longer a question,
Matthew,
of what's to become of us.
Matthew!
You son of a bitch! Take me! Come into me!
But rather, what we're to become.
God damn you! Take me!
Now, what's the one thing these films have in common?
My only comment would be highly censorable.
People in trouble. And what's the easiest way to get into trouble?
Give up, John. Admit who you are.
You know as well as I do, this necklace is imitation.
Sex.
She loved me, man.
And it always has been.
Even in this light, I can tell where your eyes are looking.
Life, sex has its dangers.
I shouldn't have been so rude. Thank you for picking up.
Because it makes people take chances. But usually, they survive. In a terror film, you don't even have to take a chance. Just take a walk, alone at night, and that may be the last we see of you.
Oh!
A moonlight swim in the nude is definitely a bad idea.
Max.
In the bedroom, anything can happen.
Please don't.
No, we take Master Charge, Visa, American Express, but not for tips.
Heaven help you if sex is your profession.
Okay, that's not really true. You can put tips on Visa if you want.
These films will put an end to your career. Permanently.
Oh, my angel. Oh, my angel. Oh. Oh.
He orders me to strip. I do it. Keeping one eye on the razor. He drops his pants and forces me down on my stomach, kneels down behind me, and rests the cold blade.
Terror film, sex rarely ends with pleasure. It ends in violence.
I'm gonna take my hand off your mouth. If you scream, bam! Now let's try it. That's good. That's real good.
Thank you. And since you're never more vulnerable than when you're naked. The bathroom is the most dangerous place of all.
To you when I say that there are little corners in everyone which we're better off left alone.
Hello?
I watched you today.
What?
But that's your stock and trade, isn't it? A man's weakness. Little sicknesses which should never be exposed.
Would you mind not doing that?
And I was never really fully aware of mine until you brought them out. I have no idea what I'm going to do. And I'm so deeply puzzled. I've done terrible things. I've killed 3 people. But yet I don't consider myself a terrible man. Others. I know you're expecting some kind of extravagant behavior, so it doesn't make any difference what I do anymore, does it?
I will not harm you at all physically.
Why don't you make yourself comfortable? Why don't you take your clothes?
I am perfectly comfortable. Just put your head down. You have this lovely, long, blonde hair. Turn your head. Like that.
Films were dominated by the classic figures. Frankenstein, Dracula, and the Wolfman. But as the years passed,
the Bride of Frankenstein,
they began to lose their shock value and found themselves being used to create the opposite effect.
We're going up to that castle.
What about that woman?
Oh, she's only trying to scare us.
Well, she's doing a very good job of it.
Yeah, come on.
Oh, no, no. Please don't wear that.
What's the matter?
I know you think I'm crazy, but in a half an hour, the moon will rise and I'll turn into a wolf.
You and 20 million other guys.
As horror and comedy became more intertwined, it was hard to know how to react. Or how to feel.
Yeah, operator, get me the Landmother County Sheriff's Department, quick.
And listen, all the cousins of Louisiana, it isn't for the queasy, for the weak of heart. Well, you had better start the home while there's still time.
Never sing my music again. Not here, not anywhere. Do you understand? Never again. My music is for Phoenix. Only she can sing it. Anyone else that tries dies.
I don't know what's making me smile. The world is sick, I'm used to it. Wouldn't you agree?
You wouldn't be able to do these awful things to me if I weren't still in this chair.
But you are, Blanche. You are in that chair.
No place to hide, no ones who they seem. Safe as long as they stay on that screen. If someone's gotta go, you know, better them than me.
The newsreel's turned into a werewolf.
On the land or in the skies, try and kill it, it flies. It dies. The night very nice, it dies.
It dies.
It dies. By the way they treat their pets, they deserve just what they get. Yet when they die, I ought to cry. I laugh instead. I wonder why.
Oh. Put me down.
Alright, my mind is clear and free. No fly is gonna get the best of me. Maybe bats are misunderstood. Here come the frogs, there goes the neighborhood. People are no damn good. I'm rooting for the shark. Mother Nature's had one too many. Don't look for cops, they're never in it. Don't sit there like a dummy, waiting in the dark. On the ladder in the skies, try and kill it, crawl the flies. It dies, they're not very nice. It dies, it dies, it dies. The end is near, it's no surprise. Blow the kiss and wave goodbye. I'm not scared, and I'm not shy. No way I'm gonna close my eyes.
It's only a movie. It's only a movie. But sooner or later, you must leave the theater and go home. Perhaps alone.
Thank you.
Thank you.